Hi everyone, welcome again in my new video. Actually, in this video, I will discuss about IPA Australia. I already recorded two videos, one of about CIPFA and another one about CIMA. So in this video, I will discuss all about IPA Australia. What is the benefit, what is the average package of IPA Australia, what is the practicing area of IPA Australia, and all other things about IPA Australia, I will discuss in this video. So this video will definitely help you if you want to go abroad like Australia. So this video will help you if you want to go in Australia or New Zealand, because IPA is recognized in both the countries, Australia and New Zealand. So I want to start my video. I want to just share my screen. CMA Institute already undertaken a MO with IPA Australia. Because of this, you are eligible for IPA membership. But all about IPA membership and benefits, I will discuss one by one. So about IPA, what is IPA? IPA stands for Institute of Public Accountant. Institute of Public Accountant is the third largest body in Australia. Okay. And the organization rebranded from its previous title, the National Institute of Accountants, NIA. Earlier, it was known as NIA. Now, after 2nd May 2011, its name was changed from NIA to IPA. Okay. So, history about the institute. In 1923, Institute was named as Institute of Factory and Cost Accountant, formed in Melbourne, Victoria. After that, its name changed again and again. And in 2011, the institute name will Institute of Public Accountant. Okay. So in 2011, its name will Institute of Public Accountant. This is the history of the IPA Australia. Firstly, it was known as Factory and Cost Accountant. After that, Institute of Taxation and Cost Accountant, National Institute of Accountant. There are the lots of time. Then name of the NIA or IPA Australia was changed. Level of membership. Actually, here there are the three levels of membership. First, associate member, second member, and third is fellow member. In India, there are the two levels of membership, associate member and fellow member. But here, three levels of the membership. Benefits. Benefit, most important benefit, if you become member of IPA Australia, you are qualified as an accountant. It means you will cover under the definition of accountant in Australia. Because there are the three bodies who are covered in the definition of accountant. First one is a chartered accountant of Australia. Second one is CP Australia, and third one is Institute of Public Accountant Australia. You are covered under definition of accountant. Due to this, you have lots of legal rights, you have lots of authorities, you can do lots of things which other professional body can also do in Australia, like CP Australia and Chartered Accountant Australia. Okay. So what is the area? Just the same slide, like this, the legal recognition of the definition and the various acts. Working area, if you go in the practice, if you want to do practice in Australia, this is the area which you can do your work, like preparation of lodgement of income tax return, advice on superannuation, definition of qualified accountant, you already covered, audit of self-merged super funds, audit of small proprietorship, audit of public companies and large proprietary company. It means you will covered under definition of accountant. It means you are eligible to become a financial auditor also in Australia. So you can become financial auditor. You can become official liquidator also in Australia. If you want to do job in Australia after taking the membership of IPA Australia, this is the average package of IPA Australia. You will earn approximately 1 lakh to 1,20,000 Australian dollar. This is the top positions which you can earn senior financial accountant. Here the key responsibility area and here the qualification and all other things are mentioned. You can just read out fees for membership. If you want to become member of IP Australia, so I already mailed to IP Australia, and this is the reply of, from the IP Australia. Dear Rohan, thank you for inquiry regarding IP membership. Being a member of ICI, you are eligible to apply full membership of IPA at member MIPA. That is the second level of the membership. Please complete attached application from and email back to us with below supporting documents like your CV, your other qualification and all the things about you. You just submit them. And the fees approx Australian dollar 485, in which certificate fees is Australian dollar 85, administration fees Australian dollar 45, and MIPA annual subscription fees, which is Australian dollar 355. If you convert into Indian rupees, it's around 29,000 to 30,000. So just I will suggest you, if you want to go Australia, then you will take the membership. Otherwise, you will not take the membership, because this membership will help you when you will go abroad in Australia and New Zealand. Otherwise, this membership will not help you. It will not increase your value in India, because in India, only two professional bodies are recognized in everywhere. One is the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and another one is the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. No one is recognized in the finance background, like top PSU, Director of Finance, CEO, CFO of the PSU public sector undertakings are cost accountant or chartered accountants. No one are eligible for that. So due to this, I will suggest you, if you want to go abroad, then you will take the membership. Otherwise, you will not take the membership. This is all my slide. I will discuss some other points. Just I want to show the mails and all the things. Firstly, here the history of the mention about on the IPS side. From this I will cover. I already covered in my video. And that is the legal things about IP Australia, about their working areas and all other things, definition of professional accounting body, advice on superannuation, definition of qualified accountant, and the various sections of their legal provisions, they are covered at the definition of the accountant. They are mentioned here. Audit of self-merge, I already discussed about all the points. You can read out. To register as a company auditor, I already told to you. Disclosure of information to the IPA. This is some of the legal requirement and all the things. So you can read out. I will give the link in the description section. Here some recognition are also mentioned. Here, which I already told about, Australian Securities and Investment Commission. Here the definition of accountant was mentioned. There are the three bodies who are covered, which I already discussed in my video. This is some unique feature of, this is the Hodgson Accounting and Finance. Hodgson Accounting and Finance here. The salary of the IPA Australia was mentioned, which I shown in the video. Here IPA qualification are mentioned. Approach this. Yeah, you can search on Google. There are all the various other sites which will provide you the average salary package of IPA Australia. And if you want to take membership, you can just mail just like me on jangeo@publicaccountants.org.au. And they will reply you, and after that you will send all your confirmation. Here the also bank details are mentioned, which you will pay your fees and take your membership. Like here, National Australian Bank, account numbers, shift code, and all the things are mentioned. You will pay your membership fees and you will take your membership from IP Australia. So hope so, my video will guide you all the things about IP Australia. If you like this video, please share with your friends and all your colleagues who want to go abroad after qualification CMA. So this video will definitely help to all the persons. Due to this, I recorded this video in English because there lots of persons who are belong from the South India and other zone of the India, they don't know about Hindi. Due to this, I recorded my entire video in English. And it will be on premium all YouTube. Thanks. Bye. Take care. Best of luck.